people, my name's Jade, and today we're going to be talking about The Fifth Wave by Ricky Yancey. This was just the most amazingest, cool, it was like a roller coaster. Not like the Divergent roller coaster, this was the Fifth Wave roller coaster. It was so cool and amazing, it was fantastic. I would definitely recommend this one if you haven't already picked it up. Do you remember this? When I was supposed to be talking about Frostbite, but I kept talking about this. It's that one. So hopefully you've read it because you've taken my advice. Because I want what's best for you. So it's about a girl named Cassie, and she's really vicious and really cool and really tough. She's really strong and strong-willed. She's incredibly strong-willed. And she is convinced she's not going to be the last human in this alien invasion going on. This alien invasion is crazy. So basically, normal day, birds chirping and all that blah. And then, all of a sudden, mothership appears, giant green eye thing there, sky. And so, Earth reacts what I consider perfectly normal. We start to freak out. What's that? Some people start to, go to bunkers and get all their canned goods. Some people are like, oh yeah, they're friendly. They're going to come here to save us. Cassie's father believes that, I believe. I believe that Cassie's father believes that the aliens are here to help Earth. Everyone starts to panic and comes up with these crazy consumptions, and it's crazy. So Earth are reacting quite normally. And we start to send them these messages. Excuse me, what are you doing? This is Earth. Welcome, I guess. So what's your name? You here to help? And they're just no. What the hell? They ignore us. Rude. They're rude aliens. That's what they are. So 10 days go by, and on the 10th day, what happens is everything electrical, battery operated, engine, motors, all that stuff just gets shut down. Cassie's in middle school and her phone just stops working, and everything just stops working. People's music players, people's phones, the cars. They see a plane fall from the sky in their school and fall in the field. So there's no electricity, you can't drive anywhere. Lights are pretty limited, candle operation thing going on. And then all sorts of crazy, terrible, chaotic stuff begins to happen. It's very extreme. There's a quote at the beginning of this book, and I think it sums the book up so well. And I love this quote. This quote is really cool. If aliens ever visit us, I think the outcome would be much as when Christopher Columbus first landed in America, which didn't turn out very well for the Native Americans. I love that. That's by Stephen Hawking. I love that quote. I think that sums up the book really well. So if you haven't read it, go away, because I'm gonna spoil you. I would highly recommend to anyone who is a fan of Divergent or other action-packed, exciting, chaotic stories. Highly recommend. I give it 5 stars. Just, I fell in love with it. It's so easy to fall into this world and believe everything that he says. These characters are so convincing, and the impact on you is really quite large. It's very, very good. So go away, shoo, if you haven't read the book. If you have, welcome. If not, shoo. The atmosphere and the vibe and the style of this was just amazing. The writing style and the atmosphere, the vibe given off by it was just so cool. I'm speechless. I don't know what to say. I'm trying to think of things to fault it with. Because that's what normally I do. I normally fault things and then tell you about all the good bits. But I can't fault it. The only fault is when the POV changed from Cassie to Ben. And then with the whole silencer little section. It was very confusing. I hated reading from Ben's point of view at first. I was like, no, go back to Cassie, for goodness sakes. And this whole silence thing, I was like, what the hell is this? But you, within halfway through it, it took me a while to adjust, I'm gonna be honest, but within like halfway through, I was fine and I enjoyed switching. It was like a fresh look at things, different, because everyone had different amounts of information. You know, Evan had so much, Ben had so much, Cassie had so much, Sammy had so much. Everyone knew different parts of the equation. And so we know all of it. It's one of these ones that one character's doing something the other character doesn't. And you're just like, ah. But then the other character would catch up and overtake. And then that character would catch up and overtake. And it was so cool, the way it all planned out and tied together. And oh, I loved it. I think I enjoyed Cassie's point of view more. I liked hearing the sound of her voice. That makes no sense. I liked her explanations better and the way she thought about things. I thought was really cool. But especially towards the end, with that whole when they get released upon the world, I don't know, when they get sent out and have to fight things, I loved that bit. And I loved the things that Ben went through and that happened to him. It was very chaotic. The very beginning was very intense. Lots of people have picked up this book, read the first however much, and it's like, no, I have to put this down. It's very scary, it's very upsetting, very depressing. Lots of people get bummed out, I know, but people describe it as you push past it and then there's good stuff. For me, I didn't have to push past it at all. I thought the beginning was so fascinating. I loved what was happening to the world, and I loved how dark and cruel and twisted it was, because it was interesting, I think. Am I weird? Well, I am weird. Am I sick? Possibly. So we switch point of views from Cassie. We learn about what happened to her and all her background and all her baggage and her whole situation, which I, as I said, thought was amazing and fascinating, and I loved reading that part. I thought that was so addicting. I flew through it. And then we switch to Ben. Quite clearly in the beginning of that section, there's no name. And I had no idea who it was. I honestly had no clue. And then at the end, I think, of that section, he said Benjamin, whatever, Paris. And I was like, I recognize that name. Where do I recognize that name from? Where do you recognize that name from, Jade? It took me until a little bit after that until I actually figured it out. I was like, what? Wait a minute. And I had to flip back and it's, oh no. I told you I'm bad at figuring things out. So if I couldn't figure out that it was Ben Parrish, the boy she had a crush on, how you expect me to figure out the rest of the stuff that goes on? I don't. So we have Camp Ash Pit and the soldiers go in there. And at first I'm very like, I don't know, after seeing the helicopter go by, whatever it was, and they just left, I was very skeptical and I wasn't like keen, and I kind of thought it was aliens, and so I kind of think they're aliens. And then her dad's like, come on, you two gotta get on the bus. And when Sammy had to go on the bus without Cassie, I was so scared and worried. I was worried sick. Okay, it's a very hard time. And then I was like, oh my god, he's been taken by Aiden. What's gonna happen to him? And then there's the other soldiers and they kill her dad and she has to run away and all this stuff. And I'm kind of, Sammy's been taken by aliens. Oh dear. And then we go to Ben's point of view, and then it's like a war camp thing. It's not actually aliens. We get convinced that it's not aliens. So uh-oh, Sammy's been taken by aliens. It's now, okay, we're gonna fight back. Yeah, it's really sick and twisted, but we're gonna fight back. We are not gonna die out. The reasons behind the camp was really confusing, and I didn't like that whole explanation. I don't know. I was very confused by what they were getting at. I thought it was stupid, whatever they thought. It turns out that they were aliens in the end. See, Rick Yancey has this thing where you can twist all your beliefs. See, you start to suspect something and then you confirm it's something else. Cassie never second doubted that he wasn't taken by aliens. And we just kind of totally ignored her in that sense. Oh, I don't know why it took so long to realise. If you think about it, it's so obvious because we don't have a cure. I swear Cassie said at the beginning that we don't have a cure to this Red Death or whatever. And then Ben gets cured like that. But why didn't that ring any bells? I know I'm bad at figuring things out, but once you look at it, it's obvious. And then Wonderland. That is crazy. That sounds like a very traumatizing experience. If you ask me, I think that can damage. It's a very clever idea though. Hats off to whoever designed that. But again, they wouldn't just leave it lying around for the humans to get. They can't just go, oh look, what's this? Well, I found something. What's it? What is it? And it turns out to be a way to figure out people's minds. Why would the aliens leave that around? Obvious. When they took their trackers out, Zombie and Ringer, when they took their trackers out and their head lit up green, I was so confused. And when Ringer explained it, I was like, all the suspicions at the beginning about Sammy, the aliens came flooding back. Wait, what? The fifth wave? They're the fifth wave? Aliens had turned people's minds around to believe, to go against each other is so chaotic. Like, paranoia. You're so paranoid throughout everything. There's so many options. It's so scary. If this really happened to Earth, it's so convincing as well. So if this really happened to Earth, you would believe this is the kind of thing that happened. These aliens are sick and twisted. They are, you can't figure it out. You're running into dead ends trying to figure out what's going on. It's so confusing. You're so paranoid. And then you got the whole Evan thing going on. So she gets shot in the leg and she's under the car, and in the end she comes out, but the silencer lets her go. And there's this thing with the silencer and how he lets her go, and it's obvious that he's in love with her or something. And you're like, oh, you're in love, you're gonna be human after all, like maybe he can be a good guy or something like that. And then she wakes up in this room and there's a guy that comes in and he knows about her and stuff. I immediately thought that he was the silencer, and then you forget. I just completely passed my mind. Like, I was really paranoid for a little bit, and then all of a sudden, bam, I trust him. I'm like, oh, Ben, I think he's really, really cute. I imagine him as Theo James. I really like Evan. Yeah, he's really cool. He seems a little bit too cutesy, if you get what I mean. He's almost like Augustus, but Augustus pulls it off. And then all of a sudden he blurts out about the crucifix soldier and about something else that I cannot remember. He starts blurting out about these things that happened to him. He's like, yeah, I read these diaries and it makes sense and I want to believe him. Evan, just shut your trap, just shut up. And then when he does explain to her that he was against the whole thing, I was like, oh, he's so sweet. Like, he's a good guy, so he's turned human. I believe that he is human. And they're such a cute couple. And she was being really mad at him and really, like, horrible. And I was like, no, Cassie, he's good, really. Sammy and Zombie were really cute. Nugget, that was what he was called. Nugget and Zombie, they were so sweet. And I thought it was really nice of him to take on the role. But at the same time, Nugget is a bit of, he's work. He's, mouthy for a 5-year-old, I can tell you that. And Bear had a very strong personality. When they were attacked by the fifth wave, like Evan and Cassie, I was really worried. I don't know why. And there was a grenade or whatever, and that's when he finally admitted to her that he's a silencer. And that was really tense and harsh, but it fitted in so well. It was unbelievable, and it was still really entertaining, and it was really vital. And yeah. And then we have the whole ending when she went in and she killed Dr. Pam. I thought that was so cool. I hated Dr. Pam from the very beginning. I don't know why. I hate people like that for some reason. I always hate those kind of characters. I don't know why. I just do. I don't trust them. I never trust those characters. I was like, yeah, whatever you say. And she killed her and I was like, ah, so awesome. Like, ah. Yeah, you go, Cassie, kick butt. How how it all tied and fitted together. It was Evan managed to get her in. She managed to get to Nugget. And Cassie's there like, Ben? And he's just there. I'm sorry, who the hell are you? And she's just, we studied together. The fact that it came full circle with the babies as well, I that was so cool. And she'd kind of like grown away from this whole Ben thing. It was like a little pity thing. And then the fact that they had to meet back at the end, it was kind of like the irony in that. I thought that was so cool. And how they both changed and developed from there to there, I thought it was so cool. I loved seeing them change and then come back together. And I was like, they're gonna be better than. And then Evan joins in, he's like, knock. And she's like, yes, Evan, you can come in, because he kept stalking her earlier on in the book. That was so. It was like the relief when he came. It was like, it's okay. Evan's here. He's gonna save the day. And then he went off on his own and was like, Evan, what are you doing? Come back. We kept having these splurges or whatever. Kept having these moments where Bodge. What the hell is the name? How do you say that? You know the one I'm on about anyway. He kept calling Ben weak. And then Cassie said this thing about the people that are left, they're not weak. Ben is not weak. I don't think he's weak at all. Like, he appears weak. I can understand why he appears weak. But deep down, he's not weak. He's just very traumatized. So would you be if that happened to you? Like, give him a break. I am so excited for the next one. It's called The Infinite Sea. It comes out this year sometime, and I'm so excited because this is a trilogy. I hope we get a solid conclusion. I don't want us to just assume that maybe they just, for example, if they wipe out the aliens, that I don't want to just assume that humanity reform or whatever. I want a solid based conclusion. Who is with who? Who has survived? Who has not survived? And what the hell has happened to humanity? And what has happened with the whole alien situation? So curious to find out. I can't wait. And Evan's not dead. Like, he's Evan. Evan doesn't die. He's kind of like Dumbledore. I'm talking to him like he's Dumbledore or something. He's not dead. He's too cool to be dead. He's gonna come straight back. He's gonna find her and come straight back. But that's too easy, so I reckon something really weird and twisted is gonna happen before that. I'm really, really scared. I'm so nervous. I've not had enough Evan. I need more Evan. This cover, I'm not sure like how I feel about it. It's like, before I thought it was really bad. I was like, oh, the cover. But looking at it, honestly, I like it. When I first saw The Infinite Sea, I was like, ugh. Having read this, I think it definitely fits the vibe. But I still don't like it. I've got a feeling that once I've read that book, I'm gonna like it. It's the kind of cover that reflects the story. So you have to read the story to like the cover. I like the cover now. Before, I didn't. It's not my favourite cover, but I think it definitely suits the book really well. And it's definitely cool. It's a tall book and it's all waxy and stuff. It smells nice. It's got a special smell to it. It's the Fifth Wave smell. I like it. The Fifth Wave will be turned into a film as well. I can't remember her name. It will be on screen somewhere. She was in Dark Shadows, and she's also gonna be in If I Stay. I was looking so long for song. Suspicious item has been detected. Shut up! I was looking so long for a song for this. I can't think of anything. To get my creative juices going, I came out with a little playlist of the songs on my iPod. So that's not a lot of songs, mind. That remind me the most of the Fifth Wave. What I have isn't great. I'm very limited because I only have there's a lot of songs that I like, and then I buy the most random ones, honestly. There's Skyfall. My song's Know What You Did in the Dark by Fall Out Boy. I don't know, I was thinking about the whole Crucifix Soldier thing. Can't Hold Us by Macklemore and Ryan Lewis. And then I also have If You Could See Me Now. Kind of all the dead people, if they could see the alive people, what they think. I don't know. I don't know what, I couldn't think. I was thinking rock. I don't know why, but I was thinking I need a song, a rock song for this. And so I looked on the playlist that Spotify have, and you got moods and genres and such. So I looked in rock, and I looked at a couple different legendary and Air Punch and whatever. Road Trip, I think, was one of them. I seriously considered a bunch of songs I would never consider before. I seriously considered, should I stay or should I go? What else was I considering? Let's have a look. We built this city. We built this city on rock and roll. We built this city. We built this city on rock and roll. I seriously considered that. In the end, however, I chose one of my favourite songs, and it makes sense to me, and I can really see the connection, and it was just one of my favourite songs. Let's see if you can guess. That was a bit anticlimactic. Oh, starting. Oh, my arm. Okay, that's enough. I hope you guessed that, because that's a seriously good and famous song. You should have known that. Dead or Alive? No, that's not right. Wanted, Dead or Alive by Bon Jovi. There's also the Rock of Ages version, that film, by Tom Cruise. I don't know. Is it Tom Cruise? Is it really? Who knows? It sounds like Tom Cruise, but I have difficulty believing it's really Tom Cruise. That's a good version as well, but Bon Jovi is the original. That's kind of the alien perspective on humans, if you think about it. They want them all, whether they're dead or alive. They don't care much, really. They'd like them alive so they can go out and make them kill more people. However, they'd also like them dead, because then, you know, job done. And I think the atmosphere is really, like, tense and hardcore, just like this book. So I see a lot of connections. I don't know. What do you think? Let me know down below, because I want to know. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. I hope you have a great morning, afternoon, evening, / night. My name's Jade. I'm gonna see you next time. Bye! Rainbows. Oh, okay, why can't I say that? Oh my. Well, it wasn't aliens. Well, they were kind of aliens. I don't know, that's complicated. What were they? Were they silencers? Well, they must have been, because they're not necessarily going to be aliens walking off the bus. I'm confused. No! This statistical probability of love. I can't say. Falling over. So, it's a bow only name. That was just terrible. Uh-oh. The statistical probability of love at first sight. Boom!